Blackstone Audio presents Man Riding West by Louis L'Amour. This book is read by Mark Bramhall.
Three men were hunkered down by the fire when Jim Gary walked his buckskin up to their camp in the lee of the cliff. The big man across the fire had a shotgun lying beside him. It was the shotgun that made Gary uneasy, for cowhands do not carry shotguns, especially when on a trail drive, as these men obviously were. Early as it was, the cattle were already bedded down for the night in the meadow alongside the stream, and from their looks they had come far and fast. It was still light, but the clouds were low and swollen with rain.
"How's for some coffee?" Jim asked as he drew up. "I'm riding through, and I'm sure hungry and tuckered."
Somewhere off in the mountains, thunder rolled and grumbled. The fire crackled, and the leaves on the willows hung still in the lifeless air. There were three saddled horses nearby, and among the gear was an old Mother Hubbard-styled saddle with a wide skirt.
"Light and set up."
The man who spoke was lean-jawed and sandy-haired.
"Never liked to ride on an empty stomach myself."
More than ever, Gary felt uneasy. Neither of the others spoke. All were tough-looking men, unshaven and dirty, but it was their hard-eyed suspicion that made Jim wonder. However, he swung down and loosened his saddle girth and then slipped off the saddle and laid it well back under the overhang of the cliff. As he did so, he glanced again at the old saddle that lay there. The overhang of the cliff was deep where the fire was built for shelter from the impending rain. Jim dropped to an ancient log, gray and stripped of bark, and handed his tin plate over to the man who reached for it. The cook slapped two thick slabs of beef on the plate and some frying pan bread, liberally touched with the beef shavings. Gary was hungry, and he dived in without comment, and the small man filled his cup.
"Headed west?" the sandy-haired man asked after a few minutes.
"Yeah, headed down below the rim. Pleasant Valley way." The men all turned their heads toward him, but none spoke. Jim could feel their eyes on his tied-down guns. There was a sheep and cattle war in the valley.
"They call me Red Slagle. These hombres are Toby Langer and Jeter Dirksen. We're driving to Salt Creek."
Langer would be the big one.
"My name's Gary," Jim replied. "Jim Gary. I'm from points yonder, mostly Dodge and Santa Fe. Hear they're hiring warriors in Pleasant Valley."
"Reckon." Jim refused to be drawn, although he had the feeling they had warmed to him since he mentioned heading for the valley.
"Riding that way ourselves," Red suggested. "Want to make a few dollars driving cattle? We're short-handed."
"Might," Gary admitted. "The grub's good."
"Give you 40 to drive to Salt Creek. We'll need help. From hereabouts, the country is plumb rough, and she's fixing to storm."
"You've hired a hand. When do I start?"
"Catch a couple of hours sleep. Toby has the first ride. Then you take over. If you need help, just you call out."
Gary shook out his blankets and crawled into them. In the moment before his eyes closed, he remembered the cattle had all worn a AA brand, and the brands were fresh. That could easily be with a trail herd, but the AA had been the spread that Mart Ray had mentioned. It was raining when he rode out to the herd.
"They ain't fussing," Langer advised. "And the rain's quiet enough. It should pass mighty easy. See you."
He drifted toward the camp, and Gary turned up his slicker collar and studied the herd as well as he could in the darkness. They were lying quietly. He was riding a gray, roped from the small remuda, and he let the horse amble placidly toward the far side of the meadow. 100 yards beyond the meadow, the bulk of the sloping hill that formed the opposite side of the valley showed blacker in the gloom. Occasionally there was a flash of heat lightning, but no thunder. Slagle had taken him on because he needed hands, but none of them accepted him. He decided to sit tight in his saddle and see what developed.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.